I work in an surgical intensive care unit as an intensivist and nephrologist, and I take care of the patients who developed unexpected complications that are unrelated to their surgery. About 150,000 patients a year in America dies from this complication of major surgery. So the idea was to develop autonomous intelligent system that can take all that data in real time, process it, and then predict risks or complications, not just one time, but on multiple occasions. And I put together a team of both physicians in surgery, anesthesiology, and then in computer science and IT, health IT, to see whether we can find a better way to recognize which patients are at risk for developing these complications before they go for surgery and immediately afterwards. This is a machine learning algorithm, so it trains as we go. So every 3 months, we collect the data that we have done, all the prediction, and we retrain the algorithm, improve it, and put it back in the system. We found out that when you just look at the physician's forecasting, it's probably in a zone of 50 to 60%, almost like a flip of coin. Compared to physician algorithm was better, I think that was not much of a surprise. We allowed physicians to review the algorithm output, and physicians were asked to recast their risk once they were able to review algorithm. And after they recast their risk, they were actually more precise. It's not going to replace physicians, but it's going to help them use the depth of data that exists in electronic health record and what specific intervention to prevent those complications that you are at high risk for need to be employed. I think that dynamic component and the ability to transfer the knowledge between different team of physicians is probably the biggest use of this algorithm.